Let us continue VS CPR theory. In VS CPR theory, we are taking a SF4 sulfur tetrafluoride. We are taking in this sulfur is the central atom. This sulfur central atom is having valence shell 6 electrons. This valence shell has 6 electrons. Here 2 electrons, 3rd, 4th, 5th, and 6th. 6 electrons. Surrounding atoms, fluorine atoms. Surrounding atom fluorine atoms, 1 fluorine, 2nd fluorine atom, 3rd fluorine atom, 4th fluorine atom. Okay, it is a lone pair. This what means lone pair. So this sulfur is having 1 lone pair and 4 bond pairs. So totally how much means 5 electron pairs. Totally 5 electron pairs. Sorry. Here lone pair is in which position? In the sense equatorial position. Lone pair is in equatorial position. This fluorine in equatorial, this fluorine in equatorial, this fluorine in axial, this fluorine in axial. This is one possibility. What is another possibility for this SF4? Sulfur lone pair will give in a axial position. Lone pair we have given in axial position, and fluorine atoms will give like this. Fluorine atoms will give like this. Okay, lone pair is in axial position. Sir, now we will see the type of repulsion. What type of repulsion is possible, that we will see. Yeah, in this case, this lone pair is in repulsion with this axial fluorine. Axial fluorine. How many in the sense? 2. Then lone pair is in repulsion with the equatorial fluorine. Equatorial fluorine. How many in the sense? 2. Okay. Here we will see. Here lone pair is in how many fluorines with the 90 degree in the sense? 1, 2, 3. So with the fluorine 90 degree. And it is this lone pair with the fluorine, it is nearly 180 degree. Like this is there. So here what is the angle means 90 degree. Here what is the thing means 120 degree. Here 90 degree is how many times in the sense? Here how many times in the sense? 3 times. It is 1 time. 90 degree is 2 times here. 90 degree is 3 times here. Therefore repulsion is more here. Repulsion is less here. Therefore this system is having higher stability. Therefore in this system repulsion is minimum. In this system repulsion is maximum. Repulsion is maximum. Therefore, stability is maximum for this. Stability is minimum for this. Therefore, this structure is accepted one. This structure is accepted one. This structure is incorrect. This is incorrect. It is correct. Now, this shape is what in the sense? The shape of this molecule is what in the sense? Seesaw shape. Seesaw shape. Seesaw shape. Okay. This shape is like this. So in this shape, how these fluorine atoms will be there, that we will see. Now this lone pair is making repulsion with this axial. Okay, this lone pair is making repulsion with this equatorial. Where repulsion is more means here repulsion is more. This lone pair, this bond pair repulsion is more. Therefore, this fluorine is bending somewhat here, bending towards this side. Similarly, this fluorine also bending towards this side. Therefore, how this SF4 will be there means this, yes, here lone pair will be there, here fluorine will be there, equatorial fluorine, axial fluorine, how it will be there means slightly bending like this, slightly bending like this, such that lone pair, bond pair distance is increasing, angle is increasing, repulsion is decreasing. So that this will be like this. It will present like this. Therefore, between these two fluorine atoms, angle is not 180 degree. Between these two fluorine atoms, angle is not 180 degree. Okay, it is not 180 degree. So, how many bond angles possible for this? How many bond angles possible for this case? That we'll see. Between these two fluorine atoms, one bond angle is possible. Between these two fluorine atoms, another bond angle is possible. Another bond angle. Then between these two fluorine atoms, another bond angle is possible. Therefore, totally three different bond angles possible. Three different bond angles possible for this SF4. This number 3 is less than 180 degree, not 180 degree, less than 180 degree we can say, number 3. So how the SF4 present in the sense, SF4 will be present like this, okay. So for a 5 electron pairs we said like this. Now another we will take, 5 electron pairs we said, be SF4 we said. Next we will take a ClF3 we will take. In this central atom is Cl. Cl electronic configuration is neon. 3s2, 3p5, 3d is 3d we have written. 3s contains one orbital. 3p contains three orbitals. 3p contains three orbitals. 3d contains five orbitals. 3d contains five orbitals. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Five orbitals will be there. In 3p, 5 electrons are there. I will write 3 electrons here as unpaired electrons. Remaining 2, I will write in 3d. In 3s, 2 electrons are there. 1 electron I will write in s. Remaining 1 electron I will shift to 3d. So this is what means excited state configuration. Which excited state means third excited state. First excited state means from 3p, 1 electron shifting to 3d. Second excited state means another 3p electron shifting to 3d. Third excited state means 3s electron shifting to 3d. Sir, therefore here 7 unpaired electrons are there in chlorine. Sir, now we will take chlorine. Here 7 unpaired electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 unpaired electrons we have given. In this chlorine we have given 7 electrons we have given. 7 electrons we have given. These two we will write it as lone pairs, we will write it. Then 3 fluorine atoms we will write. 1 fluorine atom here, 1 fluorine atom here, 1 fluorine atom here. Now we want 3 unpaired electrons only for ClF3. These two are lone pairs only, no? Therefore 3 unpaired electrons are enough. 3 unpaired electrons enough in the sense we can write configuration like this. This configuration is enough. That is 3s2, 3p4, 3d1. That means it is coming under which excited state do you say? That means only one 3p electron goes to 3d. Therefore, it is first excited state. First excited state is enough. So ClF3 we have given like this. Now we will see what is the shape of this ClF3. That we will see. The shape of ClF3 is what means a T shape. The shape of ClF3 is a T shape. Okay. Now, these two fluorines are just like axial. This fluorine is axial. These two lone pairs equatorial. Equatorial like this you can say. These two lone pairs and fluorine in equatorial. These two fluorine atoms in axial. Okay. Here lone pair bond pair repulsion. Here bond pair repulsion. This lone pair will make higher repulsion. Therefore, these two fluorine atoms, this fluorine move like this. This fluorine moves somewhat down. This fluorine also moves somewhat down. Why these two fluorine atoms moving somewhat down? Because of this lone pair repulsion. Due to that, this F will be like this. F will be like this. And the lone pairs will give like this. Lone pairs are giving like this. Therefore, between these two bond pairs, bond angle is not 180 degree, less than 180 degree. Between these two bond pairs, bond angle is less than 180 degree. Then between these two bond pairs, bond angle is less than 90 degree. Between these two bond pairs, bond angle is less than 90 degree. Between these two bond pairs, bond angle is less than 180. Between these two, less than 90 degree. How many bond angles possible in this case in the sense? 2 bond angles possible. For this case, 2 bond angles possible we can say for ClF3. Okay. Now, here 5 electron pairs. 5 electron pairs in the sense, what are the things we discussed? One is PCl5. In PCl5, all the 5 electron pairs are bond pairs. For this, what is the shape in the sense? Trigonal bipyramid. Another 5 electron pairs is what in the sense? This seesaw, SF4 seesaw. Here, one lone pair, 4 bond pairs. One lone pair, 4 bond pairs. Okay. Here, how many bond angles possible in the sense? 3 bond angles possible. In this SF4, 3 bond angles possible. Okay. Next one is ClF3. In this central atom, Cl is having 5 electron pairs, 2 lone pairs and 3 bond pairs. 2 lone pairs and 3 bond pairs. Therefore, totally 5 electron pairs. This shape is a T shape. Here, how many bond angles possible in the sense? 2 bond angles possible. Okay. Another 5 electron pairs, I3 minus. This we will discuss after discussing dative bond. After discussing dative bond or coordinate colon bond. After discussing coordinate colon bond, we will discuss this. Here also central atom will be having 5 electron pairs. 3 lone pairs will be there, 2 bond pairs will be there for this. Sorry, okay. Next we will go for 6 electron pairs. Next we will take 6 electron pairs we will take. Next we are taking 6 electron pairs. In the 6 electron pairs, all are bond pairs for which case in the sense SF6. SF6. SF6 if we take sulfur hexafluoride, here sulfur is 6th A group, so its valence shell contains 6 electrons. All the 6 electrons made a bond with the fluorine atoms. It is a 6 electron pair. 6 bond pairs will be there, no lone pairs here. This shape is what in the sense octahedral shape. Now we will take BrFi. In BrFi we will take bromine electronic configuration we want to write it. Okay. In order to write bromine electronic configuration, we will write a halogen family. Halogen family is fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, astatine. Okay, noble gases if we write here helium, here neon, here argon, here krypton. Therefore, for this we have to take argon, we have to take argon 3d10, 4s2, 4p5 we have to take. Because it is second period, it is third period, it is fourth period, therefore valence shell principle quantum number is 4. 4s2, 4p5 we have written. 4s contains 2 electrons. 4p contains how many electrons in the sense? 5 electrons are there. Then 3d. BrFi means 5 fluorine atoms are there. So 5 unpaired electrons are required. Therefore, these 5 electrons we will write it as unpaired electrons. We will write these 5 electrons as unpaired electrons we have written. Okay. So this is which excited state in the sense, second excited state you can see. So bromine contains 5 unpaired electrons and 1 lone pair, that we will write. So bromine contains 5 unpaired electrons and 1 lone pair. Then we will write fluorine atoms, we will write. Here 1 fluorine, second fluorine atom, third fluorine atom, fourth fluorine atom, fifth fluorine atom. 5 fluorine atoms we have written. Then how it is there in the sense, if we join these 4 fluorine atoms, it is just like a square. These 4 fluorine atoms if we join, you will get a square shape. Okay, sir. Now these 4 fluorine atoms present in the equatorial position, this is axial, like this will be there BrFi. This lone pair can't come in equatorial position. This lone pair cannot come in equatorial position. It will be in axial only. These 4 fluorine atoms in equatorial position. This fluorine in axial position, we can say. Sir, then what is the shape of this one in the sense? Square pyramid. The shape is what in the sense? Square pyramid, we can say. Then how these will be there in the sense? This bond pair is repelling these 4 bond pairs. This bond pair is repelling these 4 bond pairs. And this lone pair is repelling these 4 bond pairs. This lone pair is repelling these 4 bond pairs. Okay. Therefore, due to this lone pair, these 4 fluorine atoms coming down. These 4 fluorine atoms coming down. Therefore, how it will be there in the sense? First, what will be there means lone pair. First lone pair will be there. Second, what will be there means bromine will be there. Third down what will be there means these 4 fluorine atoms will be there. these four fluorine atoms will be there. Okay, fourth what will be there means this fluorine atom will be there. So top, if you see this lone pair, below this lone pair what will be there means bromine will be there. Below of this bromine, these four fluorine atoms will be there. Below of that, this fluorine will be there. Okay, so because this lone pair is repelling these four fluorine atoms, therefore like this happened, sir. So here how many angles possible in the sense? It is one angle here between this fluorine and this fluorine, one bond angle possible. Between these two fluorine atoms, one bond angle is possible. Okay, so two bond angles possible for this BRFI. Two bond angles possible for this BRFI, we can say that its shape is what in the sense? Square pyramid, we can say, sir. So in this six electron pairs, one is lone pair, remaining five are bond pairs, we can say. Next we will go to two lone pairs and four bond pairs, like this we will take. In the six electron pairs, two lone pairs will take, and four bond pairs will take, like this will take. For this we'll take example is what in the sense, XeF4, xenon tetrafluoride. Xenon is forming compounds under particular conditions. Okay, xenon tetrafluoride will take, xenon electronic configuration will take, its atomic number is 54, therefore krypton will take, its nearest noble gas is krypton. Okay, krypton we have written. Xenon coming under which period we have to say? Helium first period, neon second period, argon third period, krypton fourth period, xenon is fifth period. Therefore, it is coming under 5s2, 5p6, its electronic configuration. What is the, between, for, before 5, what will be there? Means 4d10 will be there. Okay, d block elements will be there. For p block elements, before that, d block elements will be there. Okay. For which p block, d block will not be there means p block second period. Second period p block, for which before that, d block will not be there. Okay, sir, we have written like this. So here how many, the 5s2 5p6 is there and the 5d0 is there. So 5s is one orbital, two electrons. 5p is how many orbitals, means 3p orbitals, six electrons. And 5d is five orbitals. 5d contains five orbitals, we can see. This is what configuration means, ground state configuration. Now we will go to first excited state configuration. In first excited state configuration, in the sense, from 5p, one electron we have to shift to 5d. One electron we are shifting to 5d. So 5d contains one electron. Now we will go to second excited state. Second excited state means from 5d, another electron goes to, from 5p, another electron goes to 5d. Another electron goes to 5d, like this. Now number of unpaired electrons, four fluorine atoms, so four unpaired electrons are enough. So xenon we will write. We have written xenon and four unpaired electrons are there. Four unpaired electrons we have written. Then two lone pairs are there. Two lone pairs we will write. One lone pair here, another lone pair here. Okay. Then fluorine atoms we'll write. We'll write fluorine atoms like this. We have written fluorine atoms like this. We have written. What is the shape in the sense? It is a square planar. This shape is what in the sense? A square planar, we can see. And here all the five atoms are in a same plane. All the five atoms are in a same plane. That's why planar we said. Why all the five atoms are in same plane means due to this lone pair, these fluorine atoms are trying to move up. Because of this lone pair, these fluorine atoms are trying to move down. Because these two lone pairs, they're making the fluorine atoms moving up as well as down. Therefore, all the five atoms are in a same plane. Therefore, square planar in the sense bond angle will be 90 degree. Bond angle will be 90 degree. We can say all the five atoms are in a only one plane. Okay. So six electron pairs in the sense like this we said. So six electron pairs in the sense one possibility. All the six electron pairs are bond pairs. For this example is SF6. SF6 shape is octahedral. Octahedral shape. And the bond angle is how much in the sense? Only 90 degrees possible. Another possibility is what in the sense? One lone pair and five bond pairs. For this shape is a square pyramid. Here bromine is in a first lone pair will be there. Below that bromine will be there. Below that these four fluorine atoms in a square will be there. Below that this fluorine will be there. Here two bond angles possible for this. Next, One is two lone pairs and four bond pairs. Two lone pairs and four bond pairs, we can say. For this example is XeF4. Here its shape is a square planar. All the five atoms are in one plane. One lone pair is up, one lone pair is down. Bond angle is 90 degree for this cell. Six electron pairs means like this we are saying. Next we will go for seven electron pairs. Now we will take what in the sense? Seven electron pairs we will take. Seven electron pairs in the sense, all the seven electron pairs are bond pairs. For that example is what in the sense, we can say IF7 we can say. Now out of seven electron pairs, one is a lone pair, another remaining six are bond pairs we will take. Remaining six are bond pairs. That means six bond pairs means six unpaired electrons we want. Therefore, we will go to third excited state in xenon. In third excited state, 5s we need not disturb, and we will disturb 5p. From 5p, one electron we will shift to 5d. One electron we are shifting to where in the sense 5d. Now, in this third excited state, six unpaired electrons are there. That six unpaired electrons we will take. Xenon we have written. Six unpaired electrons we are writing. Six unpaired electrons we have written here. Six unpaired electrons we have written. For unpaired electrons, we will give fluorine atoms. We will give unpaired electrons making bond with what in the sense? Fluorine atoms. Unpaired electrons making bond with the fluorine atoms. Okay. And one lone pair will be there here. One lone pair will be there. Xenon is having one lone pair. Therefore, in this xenon is having one lone pair and six bond pairs. This is what in the sense XeF6. For this, what is the shape means? Distorted octahedral. Distorted in the sense deviating from regular. Not regular. Distorted octahedral. Okay, distorted octahedral is the shape. Why distorted in the sense? Because of lone pair. Because of lone pair, distortion occurs. Okay, it is called a distorted octahedron shape. Okay, so seven electron pairs means like this present. So, okay. Next, we will go for a valency bond theory. Now we are going for valency bond theory. Valency bond theory we have taken. In this valency bond theory, three topics are there. One topic is what in the sense pure orbital overlapping concept. Pure orbital overlapping concept. Okay. Next, what is there in the sense? Hybridization is there. Next, resonance is there. Now we will take pure orbital overlapping concept. What is the necessity of this concept? We want to see it. For what sake valency bond theory is introduced? Valency bond theory is introduced based on quantum mechanics. It is introduced in order to explain how bonds are formed, how covalent bonds are formed in the molecules. How covalent bonds are formed. That is explained mathematically because it is based on quantum mechanics. Quantum mechanics means completely mathematical oriented. Quantum mechanics derives position of electron mathematically. So position of electron, energy of electron, everything is mathematically derived, mathematically said, mathematically explained, because we cannot see the electron. So this valency bond theory is based on quantum mechanics, means valency bond theory is completely mathematical oriented. It is introduced in order to explain covalent bonding, how bonding is possible. It is explaining a bond formation. It explains about a bond formation cell. So in this one, first topic is what in the sense pure orbital overlapping concept. In this we will see about a elementary idea. So this valence bond theory says what in the sense pure orbitals from atoms overlapping to form a bond. What is called overlap? Overlap means intermixing of two electron clouds partially. This is called overlap. That's all. Overlap is nothing but what? Intermixing of two electron clouds partially. That is called overlapping. So what is pure orbital? Pure orbital in the sense that orbital will have particular nature. suppose s orbital, if we take that s orbital will have 100% s character, then that is called pure orbital. If we take p orbital, that p orbital will have 100% p character, then that p orbital is called pure orbital. So we are taking pure orbital. That pure orbital undergoes overlapping. Overlapping means intermixing of two electron clouds partially. That overlapping due to that covalent bond is created. That is this concept. So now we will take hydrogen. Two hydrogen atoms on combining give what in the sense hydrogen molecule. Hydrogen molecule. This we will take. Two hydrogen atoms on combining to give what in the sense hydrogen molecule. This point will take. For this hydrogen atom, we are considering nucleus. Then we are considering its electronic configuration 1s1. That 1s electron cloud we will consider. This 1s is what in the sense spherical and symmetric. S in the sense spherical and symmetric. This is what in the sense spherical and symmetric. This electron we will consider as a cloud. Okay. For this hydrogen atom, we will consider nucleus and its electronic configuration is 1s1. That S in the sense is spherical and symmetric. That is spherical and symmetric we will consider here. Okay. So for this hydrogen atom 1s1, its S means spherical and symmetric. This electron we will consider as a cloud like this. Now, what happens means this nucleus is attracting this electron cloud. Due to attraction, they are coming closer and closer. At one stage, this electron cloud surface and this electron cloud surface will be in contact. Even then, attraction dominates. Therefore, the two electron clouds, intermixing partially. After intermixing partially, they are stopping in order to move still more closer. Now they are coming closer. To what extent they are coming closer? To how much distance they are coming closer in the sense? They are coming closer such that the two electron clouds intermixing partially, up to that distance they are coming closer. Now this nucleus of this hydrogen, nucleus of this hydrogen. This part is called intermixing of two electron clouds partially. That means this electron cloud and this electron cloud, both electron clouds intermixed partially. After coming to this much distance, they are not going still more closer. Why? Because repulsion is dominant. Repulsion in the sense this nucleus and this nucleus, repulsion is possible. Okay. So this electron cloud, repulsion is possible. So after coming to certain distance, what happens means they are stopped closer. They stopped moving. That means neither coming closer nor moving far away. At one distance, they stopped with each other. At that distance, what is the distance between these two nuclei? That distance is called bond length. Okay. At a particular distance, these two atoms stop moving in the sense neither coming closer nor going far away. So at particular distance they stopped moving. That means at that distance, the distance between the center of this nucleus to this center of this nucleus is called bond length. That means a molecule is formed. Molecule is formed, we can say. Okay. So molecule is formed at that distance. That point we can say. Okay. This part is called overlapping. That means intermixing of two electron clouds partially. Now see, this electron cloud and this electron cloud, is it intermixed completely here? No, partially intermixed. This is called overlapping. Due to this overlapping, bond is created. That's what this pure orbital overlapping concept says. Okay, sir. Now, what is overlapping? That we said pure orbital in the sense this s orbital coming from this hydrogen atom, this s orbital coming from this hydrogen atom, this orbital has only s character. Therefore, it is pure orbital. This orbital coming from only this atom, this is having only s character. Therefore, it is pure orbital. These two these two pure orbitals overlapping and giving what in the sense bonding, sir. Now what is the type of this overlap that we'll see. Now we will take an imaginary axis. We will draw an imaginary axis. This imaginary axis is passing through the center of this nucleus and passing like this, passing through center of this nucleus. This imaginary axis is called what in the sense, internuclear axis. This imaginary axis is called internuclear axis. So internuclear axis means it is imaginary axis which is passing through center of this nucleus, continues like this and passing through center of nucleus and coming out like this. This axis is called what in the sense, internuclear axis we can say. Now here how the overlapping takes place here. Okay, overlapping is along the internuclear axis. Overlapping here how the overlapping is taking place means overlapping is taking place along the internuclear axis. This overlapping is called axial overlapping. We can say axial overlapping, head on overlapping. We can say head on overlapping. Okay, end on end overlapping. Why end on end overlapping means one part of this electron cloud and one part of this electron cloud are overlapping here, therefore end on end overlapping. Why head on overlapping means these two are directly making collision, therefore head on overlapping. Okay, such a type of overlap results a bond. That bond is called what bond in the sense, sigma bond. That bond we have to call it as sigma bond we have to call. So this is what in the sense, sigma bond we can say. For sigma, symbolic representation is like this. So this bond we can say that sigma bond. So sigma bond means that is due to axial overlap or head on overlap or end on end overlap. This overlap, how it takes place in the sense, along the internuclear axis. If the overlap takes place along the internuclear axis, then that bond is called what in the sense, sigma bond we can say, sir. Now we'll take next bond we'll take. Before that, this sigma bond, how to denote in the sense, this sigma bond is denoted by overlapping between this s orbital and this s orbital. Therefore we can call this is as this bond is a sigma ss bond. SS bond in the sense, two s orbitals are overlapping. This s orbital is overlapping in this s orbital, so therefore we got this sigma. Therefore it is called what in the sense, ss overlapping we can say. So next we will take a hydrogen atom combining with the fluorine atom to give HF molecule. That we will take. For hydrogen atom, electronic configuration is 1s1. So for this hydrogen atom, we'll take nucleus. It's a s orbital. S orbital is spherical. That is spherical and symmetric. That s orbital will take it. It is having one electron, we can say. Then fluorine electronic configuration, if you see what is electronic configuration, means helium 2s2 2p5. So 2s contains how many electrons, means 2 electrons. 2p contains how many electrons, means 5 electrons. 2p contains 5 electrons. Okay. This is what in the sense 2pz, it is having unpaired electron, we can say. This 2pz is having unpaired electron. So we can write 2pz like this. 2pz like this. And 2pz is p orbital is double double. P orbital is double. Sorry. P orbital is double. That p orbital will write. That nucleus will write. Fluorine nucleus. It is having one electron. That one electron will write. Okay. Now here this s orbital and p orbital undergoing overlapping. Okay. S orbital and p orbital undergoing overlapping. That overlapping we will give you. Here we are giving s orbital nucleus. Then here we are giving p orbital. Here we are giving p orbital. That nucleus. Here overlapping. Overlapping means intermixing of two electron clouds. Intermixing of s electron cloud and p electron cloud partially. That is called overlapping. Sir, here how the overlapping takes place? That will say. Here we will write internuclear axis, we will draw. Here it is an imaginary axis. This imaginary axis passing through two nuclei, center of two nuclei, therefore it is called centers of this imaginary axis is passing through centers of these two nuclei, therefore it is called internuclear axis. Now here overlapping takes place along the internuclear axis. Overlapping takes place along the internuclear axis, therefore it is called a sigma bond. Okay, this is called a sigma bond. This sigma bond is formed by overlapping between this s orbital and this p orbital, therefore it is called sigma sp bond, we can say. So next we will take another molecule, that fluorine atom combining with another fluorine atom to form fluorine molecule. Fluorine molecule will take. For this fluorine atom, electronic configuration is this one. This fluorine is having one unpaired electron in 2pz orbital. That 2p is nothing but double. That double will write like this. Okay, it is fluorine. For this we will write nucleus, it is having one electron. For this fluorine we will write a dumbbell shape. We will take dumbbell shape. This dumbbell shape is having like this. And for this fluorine nucleus we have written, it is having one electron we have written. Now these two p orbitals undergo overlapping here. Those two p orbitals undergoing overlapping here, it is one p orbital. It is one p orbital. Here another p orbital here. Another p orbital. Two p orbitals undergoing overlap. Here we will write nucleus. Here we will write nucleus. The two p orbital electrons are overlapped. Therefore we got here electron pair. It is called bond pair. Now here how the overlapping is there? Is it along the internuclear axis? That we will see. Now we will write imaginary axis. It is passing through center of this nucleus, continues like this, and passing through center of this nucleus and coming, therefore it is called internuclear axis. Here overlapping takes place along the internuclear axis, therefore it is called a sigma bond. This sigma bond is formed by overlapping of these two p orbitals. This is a 2pz orbital, it is also 2pz orbital. Okay, due to these two p orbitals overlapping possible, therefore this sigma bond is called a sigma pp bond. Sigma pp bond, we can say. Okay, so now we will take a two oxygen atoms on overlapping. Two oxygen atoms combine to give what in the sense oxygen molecule. Here we have written between two atoms, two bonds we have written. In the previous case, one bond we have written, it is called a single bond, we can say. This is called a single bond, we can say. Now we are saying it is what in the sense double bond. We can say it is a double bond, we can say. Here double bond is there. Now we will take a oxygen electronic configuration. Oxygen electronic configuration is helium 2s2 2p4. So this 2p contains how many unpaired electrons? We'll see here two electrons, here one, here one. Two unpaired electrons are possible for this oxygen atom. These two unpaired electrons present in, for example, 2py, 2pz. 2py and 2pz are perpendicular to each other. 2py and 2pz are perpendicular to each other, we can say. So it is a nucleus. Now we'll write it is a 2pz atomic orbital. 2pz atomic orbital will say like this. It is 2pz atomic orbital contains one electron, and 2py atomic orbital will take like this. 2py atomic orbital we have taken like this. It contains one electron. Similarly, for this oxygen atom, we will take it is a nucleus of oxygen atom. It is a 2pz atomic orbital. 2pz atomic orbital, it is what in the sense 2py atomic orbital. 2py atomic orbital. So if this is what in the sense 2py, it is what in the sense 2pz. Now both oxygen atoms come closer for forming oxygen molecule. Now what happens means this 2pz orbital, this 2pz orbital coming closer. This 2pz orbital, this 2pz orbital coming closer. Coming closer in the sense they are going for overlapping like this. Two 2pz orbitals coming for overlapping like this. Here nucleus, here nucleus. So this is one 2pz atomic orbital. This is one 2pz atomic orbital. They are overlapping like this. They are overlapping.